Today we shall discuss only manual firing systems and will restrict it to this only, and automatic system would be discussed in the next module. The importance of manual mechanism is that the cartridge is loaded by the system itself, while there are many methods of firing manually. Number one, bolt action mechanism, brake action mechanism, lever action mechanism, and slide action mechanism. Of all these, the simplest one is bolt action mechanism, which is mostly used in long barrel firearms, that is rifled firearms, because of its being robust and having a potential strong enough that it can be used in these rifles. Examples are 303 rifle or 0.22 inch rifle. These are using bolt action, which is not only simplest but is most commonly used in these long barrel firearms. In the bolt action mechanism, there is a knob of the bolt, and this knob moves in a particular direction and carries along with it a cartridge which is used for closing the opening of the chamber, and at the same time it cocks the weapon and now it becomes ready for use. The extractor and ejector carry out the work and throw the cartridge empty case outside the weapon. The examples of this are 303 rifle and 0.22 inch rifle. These are having extractor and ejector and are commonly used. The knob is moved in a particular direction, which closes the opening of the chamber, at the same time cocks it, makes it ready for this. But everything is done manually ultimately, and therefore we call it a manual system, very commonly used. There are different parts which we shall describe in this module. The barrel and other related parts would be discussed simultaneously. It may be noted that the firing assembly exist in the bolt action itself. The firing assembly is contained in it and it takes the cartridge along with it. We shall discuss various parts of the firearm, such as magazine, ejector, extractor, barrel, and other parts, along with the mechanism already stated in this module, to give a detailed outlook of manual mechanism in total.
After studying this module, you shall be able to know about manual types firing mechanisms, classification of manual firing mechanisms, mode of action of various manual firing mechanisms. From the advent of firearms, it was a fascination that how a firearm works. From simple Roman candles to present-day fully automatic assault rifles, the firearm industry has seen a change beyond belief. As a layman, when it is a curiosity about the features and capability of a particular firearm, there is an implemented interest on the mechanism forensically. Initially, the mechanism of firearms was very elemental type and obviously much simple bearing only some easy fundamentals. But nowadays, modern scientific techniques and advanced technology made the firearm development more sophisticated. Where the initial firearms used to fire only single projectile and that too with the help of manual loading, the present-day firearms literally doesn't need to be loaded manually with added modifications. Firearms can be basically classified into following types based upon the mechanism. Manual mechanisms, automatic mechanisms. In the manual mechanism firearms, the important feature is that the cartridge is loaded to the chamber manually after firing of every round. In these types of mechanism, the cartridge-filled magazine is locked into the firearm. If it supports auxiliary feeding mechanism from which every single cartridge should be loaded and fired from the firearm. When the part of the action is moved, it catches the cartridge from the magazine or otherwise feeding sections and pushes it into the chamber where it is ready to be fired. But merely loading is not sufficient to fire a cartridge. There are certain other parameters which are needed to be taken care of, and one of such factors is the cocking of the firearm. In order to hit the percussion cap of the cartridge, it is important that the cartridge case should be in line of firing pin and that firing pin must exert sufficient force which subsequently creates a primary detonation to the primer composition. Bolt action, type of breech mechanism that was the fundamental to the development of the actually operative repeating rifle and a milestone for manual mechanisms. In the bolt action mechanism, the hanging bolt is moved in a particular direction to load a live cartridge into the chamber and to cock the firing pin simultaneously. The bolt closes the breech opening and is generally locked in the same place during the firing and leaving of projectile from the barrel until the pressure is reduced to safe level, after which the breech can be opened either by hand or by some other means. If an extractor is attached to the bolt head, the empty case can be withdrawn and subsequently ejected from the weapon. And as the bolt goes backward, it can be made to compress a spring, storing the energy which can be subsequently used to drive the bolt forward again. In this section, we will discuss about the manual loading and semi-automatic loading or self-loading actions of a firearm. The main difference between the former and the later one is based upon the mechanism of extraction and ejection of the empty round cartridge case and the loading of new round. Major parts of firearm. Action. The action is the working mechanism of a firearm. For example, bolt action. It contains the moving components of the firearm that enable loading, firing, unloading and ejection of the used cartridge casings. Action is the part of the firearm that loads the cartridge and ejects it and consists of lever, pump, bolt and semi-automatic action. Of these four actions, lever, pump and bolt are found in firearms which fires a single round. Firearms that can shoot multiple rounds or repeaters include all these types of actions. But only the semi-automatic does not require manual operations between rounds. A truly automatic action is found on a machine gun. Receiver. The receiver is the frame which contains the operating or moving parts of the firearm and includes the breech, which is usually the part of the barrel that includes the chamber into which a cartridge or projectile is loaded and firing mechanism. Bolt. The bolt blocks the rear of the chamber and is a mechanical moving part of a firearm. It is the locking and cartridge head supporting mechanism of some firearm designs that contains the firing pin, extractor, and sometimes the ejector. Trigger mechanism. The starting point of firing and the mechanism of firing is the trigger. When the trigger is pulled via the trigger mechanism, the hammer is released. The hammer strikes the firing pin or primer directly, depending on the firing mechanism. Barrel. The projectile passes through a long hollow tube called as the barrel. That portion of the barrel through which the projectile exits is the muzzle end. The barrel of the firearm may be rifled or smoothbored, and the inner portion of the barrel is termed as bore. Stock. It is the portion of the gun that is held or shouldered. This term is usually for long arm firearms and refers to the end of the firearm which is positioned into the shoulder for the purpose of supporting the firearm during aiming and firing and transferring some of the recoil. The part of the firearm which is under the receiver and barrel is called the fore-end stock. Magazines. A magazine, on the other hand, is a container that holds the cartridges. Sometimes magazines themselves are loaded with cartridges by clips. On most firearms, a magazine is detachable and replaceable. Ejector. It is the mechanism on a firearm which ejects or expels a cartridge or cartridge case from a firearm. In order to fire smoothly and uninterruptedly, the empty case must be removed from the action so the succeeding round can be fed. The ejector customarily ejects the case of the firearm by pressing against the rear of the case opposite the ejection port. The ejector can be an immovable piece of metal which strikes the case when it and the bolt reach a certain position. This is called a fixed ejector. Another type of ejector is a spring-driven plunger in the face of the bolt. When the case is free of the chamber, the plunger forces the case to flip out of the port. Extractor. It is the mechanism on a firearm that withdraws a cartridge or cartridge case from the chamber of a firearm. In bolt action, lever action, pump action, and semi or fully automatic firearms, extractors characteristically work in combination with ejectors to get rid of completely fired empty cartridges case from the weapon. The extractor removes the cartridge case from the chamber, principally dragging the case to the rear. At some point in the backward travel, the case usually makes contact with the ejector, which expels the used case out of the firearm, making area for an unfired cartridge to be loaded. Firing pin. A characteristic firing pin is a small rod of steel with the end that strikes the primer rounded in a hemispherical contour and toughened. The rounded end makes certain that the primer is indented rather than punctured, as would happen if the firing pin were sharply pointed. Most firing pins have a spring to impulse them out of the interaction with the primer and often will have an incorporated passive safety mechanism such as a block that precludes them from moving forward except the trigger is depressed. Classification of manual firing mechanism. Bolt action mechanism. Bolt action firearms operate by opening and closing a bolt. The bolt can be lifted up and back to see whether the chamber is loaded. Generally, if the chamber is loaded, a cartridge is ejected when the bolt is opened. In bolt action weapons, a turning bolt slides in an extension to the barrel. This is basically the same system as in turn bolt used to lock a door. Pushing the bolt forward brings the bolt face into battery with the breech end of the barrel and cocks the striker or firing pin. Turning the bolt when locks it into place via bolt lugs engaging with slots in the barrel extension. The mechanism combines the firing pin, a spring and an extractor all contained in a locking breech block. The spring-loaded firing pin slides back and forth inside the bolt, which itself is the breech block. The bolt is moved back and forth and partially rotated in the receiver by a projecting handle with a round knob. One or more lugs at the front or rear of the bolt or at both fit into slots in the receiver and lock the bolt firmly in place against the base of the cartridge chamber when the rifle is to be fired. As the bolt is thrust forward, it pushes the cartridge into the chamber and cocks the piece. The trigger releases the spring-driven firing inside the bolt. After firing, the extractor on the head of the bolt removes the spent cartridge and ejects it. The bolt moves the new cartridge from the magazine and repeats the process. Other bolt-action weapon cock the striker on the opening of the bolt. Straight, pull bolt actions also exist in which the rotary motion requires to turn the bolt locking lugs into the recesses is applied by studs on the bolt which slide in spiral grooves cut into the barrel extension. Bolt-action weapons are generally magazine-fed, either by a tubular magazine under the barrel, through the buttstock or via a magazine under the bolt. Some bolt actions lock without rotating. Straight pull bolts are used in the Canadian Ross, the Austrian Mannlicher, and the Swiss Schmidt Rubin rifles. Bolts that turn to lock have been standard in the Krag Jørgensen, Lee Enfield, Springfield, and Label rifles among others. Lever action mechanism. In the lever mechanism, a handle is fixed below the trigger and acts as the trigger guard in the normal position. When it is pushed forward, a rod is pulled backward and it extracts the fire cartridge and cocks the firearm. Simultaneously, the carrier bolt is pushed upward, which carries live cartridge. When the lever is brought to its normal position, the rod places the live cartridge in the chamber and the carrier block takes its original position and the firearm is ready to fire. Once a lever action gun is cocked, the only way to uncock it is to clutch the hammer and squeeze the trigger. In contrast to bolt action, semi-automatic or selective fire weapons, most lever action firearms are rifles, but some lever action shotguns and a few pistols have also been produced. One of the most celebrated lever action firearm is the Winchester Model 1873 rifle. Due to the sophisticated rate of fire and shorter overall length than most bolt-action rifles, lever-action have persisted prevalent to this day for sporting use, specifically short and medium-range hunting in forest, scrub or bushland. Slide-action mechanism. In slide-action weapons, which are also referred to as pump action or trombone action, the breech block is attached via operating rods to a movable forend. On pulling back the forend, the mechanism locking the breech block to the barrel is released. By pulling the forend to the rearmost extent of its travel, then pushing it forward, the empty cartridge case is ejected. A fresh round is loaded into the chamber and the action is cocked. Pump actions are common on shotguns. In pump action shotguns, the mechanism works by pulling the forestock to the rear to open the chamber. Eject the empty cartridge case and pick up the next round from the magazine. Pushing it forward again chambers the new round, most often fed from tubular magazines, but Examples with detachable box magazines can be found. Break action mechanism. A break action is a type of firearm where the barrel are hinged and can be broken open to expose the breech. There is a knob under the barrels through which a pin passes and the barrel swivel on this pin. This is also a aperture cut into the other side of the knob. When the barrels are closed back in place, the user turns the lever in front of the trigger guard, which pushes the projection into the slot, thereby keeping the barrels from moving upwards. When the barrels are tilted upwards, the user can remove the old cartridges, insert the new cartridges into the barrel, and then close and lock the mechanism. Multi-barrel break action firearms are usually subdivided into over and under or side-by-side configurations for two-barrel configurations or combination gun when mixed rifle and shotgun barrels are used. Initial firearms were used to be of simple mechanism of manually loading, usually, from the muzzle end and had no specific mechanism of firing as comparable to the modern day firearms. Since the propellant mixtures and the projectile were used to fed in the barrel manually, the former would burn either completely or partially, but the latter would expel from the barrel. Hence, no as such requirement of explicit mechanisms. As soon as the developments were advanced in the field of firearm manufacture, the experts as well as the users felt the requirement of some sort of dedicated machinery which could work in a precise manner to operate the firearm, which were now more advanced as compared to the older days firearms. During the course of inventions, different categories of firing mechanisms were designed. Some of them were still required in the manual involvements, be it the initial loading of the first cartridge or at every stage of loading of the cartridge. Firing mechanisms were therefore categorized into two broad categories. First was manual firing mechanism containing the bolt action mechanism, lever action mechanism, pump action mechanism, and the second one is the automatic mechanisms like gas-operated mechanism, blowback mechanism, recoil mechanism, and nevertheless the semi-automatic mechanism. The bolt action mechanism is the widely used mechanism in the present-day firearms, especially in the long rifles due to its robust working potential. It could be said as the simplest mechanism in the set of manual mechanisms. The other mechanisms like pump action or the trombone action mechanisms are generally found in the shotguns containing more than one cartridges in the housing chamber or magazine. Lever action mechanisms were not in vogue in the present days because of uncommon loading mechanism. However, in the foreign countries, they are still proving themselves in the sports.